In this edition of the Parliament Report, Sharon Hay Webster crosses the floor in the House, Christie widens probe of UDC, and cases involving small amounts of ganja to be sent to petty session courts. The razor-thin majority of the ruling Jamaica Labour Party JLP administration has inched up in Parliament, with Independent Member of Parliament Sharon Hay Webster crossing the floor and joining the party. This moves the JLP's majority to 33 as against the opposition PNP's 27. Hay Webster, a third-term MP who came to Parliament on a People's National Party ticket, joined the government side on November 1. She resigned from the PNP in June this year and was an independent MP up until October 31. The South Central St. Catherine MP told her parliamentary colleagues that she had started the process of renouncing her United States citizenship. Jamaica's constitution bars persons who are under acknowledgement of allegiance or obedience to any foreign power from serving as a parliamentarian. Hay Webster also said she would be resigning as MP. Asked when she intends to resign, she told reporters, "I can't answer that now." The newest JLP MP told the House of Representatives that she decided to join the Andrew Holness-led parliamentary majority because she is inspired by the vision of the new Prime Minister. The Office of the Contractor General, the OCG, a commission of Parliament, has widened its probe into the Urban Development Corporation's attempted divestment of 35 West Parade in Kingston to Bashco Trading Company Limited. At the same time, the Parliament report has learned that the Auditor General's Department is conducting a performance audit of the UDC. The audit started in August, months before divestment issues related to the agency hit the airwaves and appeared in the print media. Contractor General Greg Christie explained that his office had decided to expand its investigation after being notified that another tenant at the premises sought to acquire the property for years. Henlin Gibson Henlin, HGH, the legal firm representing Fifth Avenue Traders Limited, told the OCG that its client has been a tenant at 35 West Parade for more than 30 years. According to HGH, its client had made several offers and proposals to the UDC from the mid-1980s to either purchase the property or to secure a long-term lease, but to date, they have been rejected. The attorney said the company's most recent proposals to the UDC were made in January 2010, July 2011, and on August 9, 2011. Fifth Avenue Traders reportedly made an offer of $32 million for the property. Bashco Trading was in negotiations with the UDC to purchase the property for $31.4 million. The UDC had admitted to the OCG that it contravened the government's privatization policy and procedures when it attempted to sell the property without publicly advertising the land. The UDC had advised the OCG that it was taking steps to request the termination of its pending sale agreement of its property at 35 West Parade to comply with the divestment process. Another tenant, Michael Mahfood, had complained to the OCG that he also wanted to purchase the property and made offers to the UDC which were rejected. Mahfood also occupied the premises for 30 years. The general manager of the UDC, Joy Douglas, has since been suspended by the board pending an investigation into the matter. In a groundbreaking move to reduce the heavy backlog of cases before the resident magistrate, RM Court, the Andrew Holness administration has set in motion plans to transfer cases involving the possession of small amounts of ganja to the petty session courts. This means that if a person is arrested for a ganja spliff or about 8 ounces of the weed, the matter is likely to be sent to the petty sessions court for adjudication. However, where persons flagrantly and indiscriminately smoke or use ganja in public spaces, those cases would automatically be referred to the RM court. In addition, if an accused pleads not guilty, the case will also be sent to the RM court for hearing and disposal. In a statement to the House of Representatives on November 1, Justice Minister Dalroy Chuck said this policy decision did not mean that the government was softening its stance against the illegal substance. He stressed that the proposed movement of cases involving the possession of small amounts of ganja to Petty Session Court was not a signal that the government was advocating the decriminalization of the use of ganja. And this has been another edition of the Parliament Report. Thanks for logging on. Join us next time for another bulletin. Until then, I'm Edmund Campbell saying, walk good.
Jamaicans, prepare to head to the polls. And the Gleaner Group is your political authority. It's your vote, Jamaica elections. From Morant Point to Negril Point, we've got you covered.
We have the largest network of correspondents, the most
experienced political reporters,
and the most insightful team of analysts.
Jamaica elections, incisive, on radio, online, on the pages of the Gleaner. Tracking the elections from every angle, every constituency, until the last ballot is counted. The Gleaner, Power 106 FM, and JamaicaGleaner.com. Your vote on your political authority. Your vote, your voice.